Well, the controversy over the White House's birth control mandate today moved to Capitol Hill. Health and Human Services Secretary Kathleen Sebelius testifying for the first time since President Obama said his administration will find what he calls an accommodation for religious institutions. Instead of forcing those institutions to offer free birth control coverage, which would violate their beliefs, the benefit will now come directly from insurers. Lawmakers questioning, however, whether the new rule still steps on religious freedom.
Did you or anybody at HHS conduct or request any analysis of the constitutional or statutory religious freedom issues? That's a simple question.
Well, we certainly had our legal department look at a whole host of legal issues.
Did you ask the Justice Department?
I did not. No, sir.
Okay.
Joining me now for a fair and balanced debate, radio talk show host Monica Crowley and Sally Kohn, who is founder of MovementVision.org. Both are Fox News contributors. So it's not going away. It's not going away. I mean, you know, President Obama, I think, thought it was going to go away on Friday. Here we are on Wednesday. We're having hearings on it on Capitol Hill. Heard Archbishop Timothy Dolan, Cardinal Desiccant, and raising serious concerns about it. And now, before I want to get the panel to weigh in on this, Mark Levin, who is a god in conservative circles, came out today and said this.
The fact of the matter is, what would happen if we were living in a functioning constitutional republic, it's not going to happen. I said, what would happen if we were living in a functioning constitutional republic is that articles of impeachment would be drawn up against the Secretary of HHS. I'm not trying to be controversial. I'm telling you how it would work for violating her oath to uphold the Constitution. They can subpoena the Secretary of Health and Human Services, bring her in front of the House, bring her in front of multiple committees of the House, and demand, excuse me, answers to a whole host of questions about her supposed authority under our Constitution to violate the Constitution.
Monica?
Yeah.
Is this going away?
First of all, I love Mark Levin, by the way, and I think he's absolutely right. He just wrote a book where he argues that we are essentially in a post-constitutional period in America where sort of the Constitution is used and abused and nobody really is playing by the rules laid out and the law of the land laid out in the Constitution. And I think he raises a good point here. To answer your question, no, this issue is not going away. I do think that there are some serious violations of the First Amendment, of religious freedom at play here, and at the very least, we should be airing these things. Now, he talked about Capitol Hill, members of Congress bringing Kathleen Sebelius to the Hill to testify. That's what we started to see today. You just played a clip of that, airing
and
some
you saw
of
Orrin Hatch
out.
Sort of going for the
right.
Did you run this
and,
by your legal people?
And that's, and you know what, Megan, that I think is really the crux of what you just played there, because when he said, she said, well, we had our legal team look at it and it was okay, and then he said, did you have the DOJ, the Justice Department, take a look at this? And she said, I did not ask them, or I did not contact Eric Holder. This leads a lot of people to believe that this decision was not based in the Constitution or in the rule of law, but was based strictly on ideology, and that's what's bothering so many people.
Sal, even if you assume that the administration has women's health and their best interests at heart with this accommodation and so on, do you think that this lives on as a political issue or as a legal issue, as we saw there?
I don't. So let's parse this out a little. First of all, if I were Kathleen Sebelius, what I would have said was, we didn't need to run this by Justice because Justice has already weighed in on this through a 2000 EEOC, Equal Opportunity Employment Commission ruling, that said that under the Civil Rights Act, not only is a requirement like this legal, it is in fact required. And let's also bear in mind, 28 states have had rules like this, actually more stringent, some of which require churches themselves to provide birth control coverage. And there hasn't been a stink until the much despised President Obama does it during an election year. But more broadly than that, this should go away as an issue. Why? Because the Catholic Hospitals Association, Catholic Charities, Notre Dame University, the institutions that would be required to comply under this, have all said they are fine and supportive of the accommodation.
Not all.
But Republicans,
no.
But the major ones have, and Republicans
no.
still want to make this
no,
a
the
political football.
So,
wait a second. But the Catholic bishops
let me just clarify that for
me,
because it was Bill Donahue
who's
the president of the Catholic League. He came out and said, in his description, he said some liberal-leaning or left-leaning Catholic groups have come out in support of it. But I don't think it's correct to say all of them.
I didn't say all. I said most. But 600 Catholic hospitals saying we endorse this. The Jesuit Association of Jesuit Universities saying we endorse this. Catholic Charities, the largest charitable.
Monica, because it's not just that. According to the latest polls, now I think it's 65% of the American people are for this as well. 59% were for it before the accommodation. 65% are for it after the accommodation. Are they beating a quiet drum, dead drum? What's the
dead horse with a drum?
Mixing our metaphors here.
Thank you. You get my question.
Look, I think that all of this was political to begin with. So we're talking about two separate issues. One is the political ramifications of this, and as you say, you've got some polls showing a majority of Americans actually agree with this. If you break it down among Catholics, Scott Rasmussen just reported 59% of Catholics actually disagree with this. So there may have been a political calculation by the White House, or at least by the Obama campaign, to try to do this and then do the accommodation
to split
Catholics.
Doesn't he need the Catholic vote?
Absolutely, and they're such a critical swing vote.
Yeah.
He actually won them with 54% last time. But if you've got Catholics then arguing amongst themselves, part of the division actually would serve his campaign.
Yeah, I've seen polls actually that suggest the Catholics support the accommodation. So leaving that aside, though, the larger issue here, and I'm going to go back to the constitutional question. I think we can be prone to hyperbole on these matters. But look, the Constitution and the very makeup of our country from our very beginning has been balancing religious freedom with individual liberty and choice. And that's exactly what the administration's trying to do. And we've always held that, yes, you have religious freedom, you have religious objections and morality, but you want to balance those. What Republicans in Congress are doing right now is actually trying to push through a law that says if you're any employer, not even a religious employer, any employer who has any moral objection, not just to contraception, but, say you don't like that a pregnancy was conceived out of wedlock. You have a moral objection to that. You don't have to provide coverage for that. Or maybe it was using IVF. You don't have to provide coverage, health care coverage for that. We draw a line in the sand and protect the larger public interest, public health, and individual rights as a nation. That is what our Constitution
says. Here's the ideological part of this, though. You know, the Obama administration has given out nearly 2,000 waivers, mostly to unions, but to other groups and other businesses around the country for Obamacare at large, right? So the fact that they won't bend on this and give Catholic institutions any kind of waiver to get out of this shows the ideological.
It's interesting in situations like the Archdiocese of Washington, for example, which is self-insured. So the saying the insurance company has to pay for it doesn't help them at all. It's still basically that the priests are going to have to cut the checks for abortifacients, sterilization, and birth control, which they don't want to do.
Talk about waivers. Churches are exempt.
But
they were from the beginning.
But the Archdiocese of Washington doesn't necessarily, that can encompass more than just the churches. Okay, got to go. Thank you both so much.
Thanks, Megan.
Pleasure as always.
You bet.
Well, the Obama administration.